Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you all the things that you can do in the Preview app to edit photos. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So the Preview app on your Mac actually is two apps in one. One is a PDF viewer, and the other is an image viewer. But both of these can be used to mark up and in some ways edit those types of files. Let's focus on image files. If you have an image file like this and you double click it, chances are it's going to open up in Preview unless you've changed the default app for those kinds of images. But you can always just run the Preview app and open any image from there. Now you get the image here in a viewer, and certainly you could use Preview just for viewing the image. Matter of fact, you can use the plus and minus buttons here to zoom in. You can use your trackpad to move around and just have it as an image viewer. But there are also some things that you could do to edit the image. Now you'll find these under Tools, and also by clicking here, which is the markup tool that gives you access to buttons here to do a lot of these functions. Let's just use the menu for now and use two items here, Adjust Color and Adjust Size. Adjust Color brings up these controls for adjusting the colors and things like exposure in the image. Now there are not as many controls here as you'll find in the Photos app or in a regular image editing app, but you do have some things like, for instance, exposure, contrast, highlight shadows, color saturation, temperature, and others here. And you could also use the controls at the top here to change the levels, and an auto levels button, and there's a reset all button. So if you have to do some basic changes to the colors or exposure in the image, you can do it in Preview. You can also go to Adjust Size, and this allows you to resize the image. So you can change it here to have it fit into a certain size with pixels, and you can change the measurement type here. Pixels is what you probably want in most cases. So here it shows you the exact pixel size of this image, and you can change it. For instance, we can shrink it to only 2,000 pixels wide. And you can see the width and height match to keep the image looking the same. But if I were to turn off scale proportionally, then I could actually scale it where it would compress or expand the image vertically but not horizontally, or vice versa. Switching to percent is another way to adjust the image. So for instance, I can go to 50% width, which would be 50% height, so about a quarter the size. You could also go to one of these measurements here and use it that way. And then you're working with the resolution here. In this case, it's 72 pixels per inch, so you have to take that into account when you're adjusting the width and height. You can also turn off resample image, and in that case, when you make a change here, you would actually be changing the resolution. So the number of pixels would be the same, but you would have a different resolution, which would mean it would be a different default size when you brought it into other apps like word processing or page layout apps. Not typically something you need to worry about, since you could just resize it in those apps. But the main thing you would use this for is if the image is too big and you really want it to be smaller. So you can say change the width to only 800 pixels wide, 600 high. You can see it's a much smaller size now. Maybe easier for you to upload to a website or to send it to somebody. Now you can also crop an image. Even without the markup tools turned on, you can see I've got crosshairs here as a cursor, and I can click and drag to select an area. Once I've selected an area, I can grab any corner or any side and readjust. If I click outside the area and drag, I'm selecting a new area. But if I click inside, I can actually move the area around. And note that when you go to select an area, if you hold Shift down, you're going to get a perfect square. And once you've selected an area, then you can go to Tools and Crop. That won't be active until you actually have an area selected. Then you can crop to just that size. And all things in Preview you can undo, so I'm going to use Command Z to undo and get back what I cropped out. There are also a few other things you can do without going to markup tools. You've got this rotate button here. You've also got under Tools the ability to flip horizontal or vertical. And now you can go to markup tools and do even more. The first tool here is a selection tool, and that's set to be a rectangle, which is what we've been using all along. But you could change it to something like an ellipse. And now I can select an elliptical area. Holding the Shift key down will give me a perfect circle. So I can select this area. Now what can I do with it? Well, if I go to crop with something that's not a rectangle, it's going to make some of this transparent. JPEG images can't have a transparent area, but PNG images can. So when you go to crop, it's going to ask to convert to a PNG. So you agree to that, and you can see now I converted to a PNG, and this area out here is transparent. If you don't want gray as the background color that indicates it's transparent, you can go to Preview, Preferences, and go to General, and you can change the window background color. So I can change it to something that may be easier to see that it's transparent. Now you can also go to a Lasso selection, which allows you to click and draw any shape that you want. And when you finish, it just automatically connects the beginning and end. So you could draw like this, release, and it connects the beginning and end there. Now, with any of these selection tools, there are other things you can do as well. Once you have this selection there, I can click and drag the selection around to reposition it. But I could also cut, copy, or delete. If I were to delete, it removes the section. It has to convert it to a PNG to do that, so now that's transparent. If I were to copy, then I could paste, and now I have a copy of that area. I can move it around to wherever I want. I can grab a corner and resize it. I can even rotate it using two fingers on a trackpad, and I could place it where I want. Using cut would be the same as doing both a copy and a delete. So then after it's deleted, now you can paste it and put it somewhere else. Another thing you could do is you could select an area and then copy and then go to File, New from Clipboard. And this creates a new preview document that just has that area that you selected. You also have the ability to use something called a Smart Lasso, which instead of a hard line is going to give you this red vague area. And you can use that to try to outline an object or subject in the photo, and it will try its best to make it fit the border of that object or subject. Now it's not nearly as good as using the equivalent tool in Pro apps like Pixelmator Pro, Affinity Photo, or Photoshop. And another problem with the Smart Lasso tool, and in fact with any of these tools, is you can only do one selection. In most other apps, you could then hold down a key like the Shift key and add to the selection, add another area, or enlarge the selection in some spot. But in Preview, it only allows you to do one selection, and then anything else you do is going to remove that selection and do another selection. Now there's also this Instant Alpha tool here. You click that, and then you click in an area, and then drag, and it will try to select similar colors nearby. As you can see here, it can grab part of the sky, but eventually it starts to grab part of the rocks. So my selection there isn't going to be as good, and I can't enlarge it by clicking on another area. It's just going to select that one area. But if you are lucky enough to get a nice clean area that's a solid color, you can then have that selection here and hit delete, and it will make that area transparent. Or you could copy and paste it. Now most of the rest here has to do with pure markup. So you can draw or sketch. With sketch, I can draw something like this, and then I get to choose either an approximation of what I just drew or the exact thing. And whichever one I do, it's going to be this object I can move around, resize. I can also use the tools over here to select the thickness of the line, the type of line, and I can even change the color right there. So then you get these kind of modifier tools here. Using draw, it draws a much more specific line, and you can't really adjust it afterwards, but you can move it around and you can change the color, but you can't change the thickness of the line or anything like that. The shapes allow you to do a variety of things. You can do lines, you can do some basic shapes like squares, circles, stars, and things like that. Each one has its own little special things, like for instance a star here has these green dots, and I could drag one of the green dots to change the number of points. I can drag another green dot to change the depth of the point as well. I can move that around. I can change the line and line color. And for the shapes that have a possible fill, you can go here to actually fill them with a color. And one interesting thing you can do is you can draw a shape like this. It remembers the last line and fill you've used, but you could also go in and click Show Colors and then change the opacity. So I can have this kind of blue filter on top of things. Let's get rid of the line completely by setting the color to nothing. And now I've just got this blue filter. I can drag it to fill the entire photo here. So Now I've got this color here. Click there, show colors, and you can see which color it is. I can change the color, change the opacity. This gives you a much wider variety of effects than just using the regular color adjustments we looked at before. You also have some cool tools here like this magnifier tool that we can adjust the size and the magnification. And then you have the text tool here which allows you to put text. You can change the text here. You can click off of it and then drag it. It's a little tricky because if you have it selected where you're actually editing text, it's hard to get back into drag mode. You have to click off and click on and drag again. For text, you want to use this button here for modifying it, including the color, font, and other things. And with it selected, you can use the trackpad, two fingers on it, to rotate the text as well. Now note that all of these different markup things, like let's put a square here, let's draw something, these are all things you can select and move around. But once you save, I'll just do Command S to save, and then reopen the file, they are now permanent. So you can't change these anymore. So the different layers you've got only work when you have the document open. As soon as you save it, they're permanent. However, Preview does allow versioning. So you can go to File, go to Revert To, and then say Browse All Versions. I've got this saved in iCloud. So if I go back a version, it's going to ask me to load from iCloud that version. And you can see here, here's the version before I put these things on when I just had a color on top of it. I can go back again here. And here's a version before I added all of that, and I can do restore. You can do signatures here on an image, although we usually associate those with PDFs. You also can access the color adjustment tools and the cropping tools from the markup toolbar here. And then finally, we have the ability to export. So after you've made changes to it, you could go to File and then Export. And then you have a variety of export options. So this allows you to use Preview as a way to convert image files. So I could go and choose a format. So you've got the better HEIC format, but not as compatible. You can set the quality here, and you can see it'll give you a smaller file size. You can go with traditional JPEG and set the quality as well. Smaller file size, better quality. You also have a share button here at the top, which allows you to send this image directly from here to a mail message or in messages, AirDrop it, add it to notes, or add this to photos. So maybe you've done some adjustments, now you want to add it to your photo library. You can do that. So editing Preview differs a lot from editing in Photos. Photos gives you better photography editing tools. There are many more ways to edit colors and exposure and things like that in Photos. But Preview allows you to do things like make parts of the image transparent, select parts of an image, cut them out, and use them in other photos. So if you really want to know how to manipulate photos on your Mac with the native tools that come with it, it's important to learn both how to use the editing tools in Photos and how to use the editing tools in Preview. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.